Hello there, my name is Duncan De Gruchy. I'm here at Bletiere for a 2-week session in early April. It's been pretty difficult conditions so far. Very cold nights, very unseasonable cold conditions. But I managed 7 carp up to 43 pounds so far, so well happy with that result. What I want to talk through for this short video is what's been introduced at Bletiere this year is these monster carp cradles. Ideal for helping to for fish safety and to make it a lot easier for anglers to handle fish when on the bank. So John London, who's the lake owner here, has introduced them this year, and a very, very good idea. So just want to talk through some of the do's and don'ts. And the first thing really is to plan where you're going to put it. Ideally you want the cradle to be very close to the rods, but also close to your where you're going to weigh the fish, and also ideally where you want to photograph fish as well. And the most important thing is to have somewhere where it's nice and stable, nice and flat. Ideally, normally situation, you'd have them closer to the rod, but the swim behind me, there's a sloping bank, so it wouldn't be good for fish safety there. There's always a chance that the fish is going to flip out. So you want it nice and stable, nice firm position, and plan this all before you're going to start your fishing, so you know exactly what you're going to do when you get that first fish on the bank. So we've got the carp cradle there. What else I've got here? We've got a bucket of water ready to, the first thing you do with that is just put a little bit of water onto the carp cradle itself. And then I would always have the wasteling ready and prepared over the top. So it's just a simple question of when I get a fish, it's in the landing net, undo the landing net handle, just bring the landing net across, place it into here, a bit of water added onto it, and then that's nice and safe because it's got high sides to this. And if you want added safety whilst you're getting everything else ready, you just put over these covers here, and that stops the fish from going anywhere. You can go away, you can put your rod, you can unhook the fish, put it all away, that's going to be nice and safe in there. You don't want to be moving the cradle at all. That's the other important thing of this. They're not designed for that. And the sort of more you try and move these things around, then you're going to get really sort of more problems with that. So once the fish is in there, you've unhooked it. I also have a wet towel I keep alongside of it, and that helps to put over to the fish's eyes. Particularly like today, we've got a nice, beautiful day here. We've got a nice sunshine, very warm. Well, it's not really, but so you can have that handy. Put it over the fish's eyes, and that just helps to calm the fish a little bit whilst you're getting ready. There's no need to rush this at all. They're in this, they're nice and safe. So once you've got that done, I've also got forceps beside the side of me just in case, and I've also got some antiseptic cream which I can put over where the hook has been, or any other sort of markings on the fish that you want to deal with that. Once you've done that, you've got the nice safe wasteling here, put it into the wasteling, zip it up, and I've got a short distance I can carry to the where I've got the wasteling, the way scale set up. This is another feature at Bletiere here where John's put these in, makes the fish weighing a lot easier. You get a good reading, nice and stable, and also has the added advantage you can put your rods in there at night as well. So that's the basics of the carp cradle. Great introduction to Bletiere, and a real useful addition. So what we're hoping to do a bit later on, we'll have a live bit of action, and we'll do a fish as we do it, as long as I can catch one, that is. Cheers for now.